So guys, today a special vlog because they invite us in a radio. So in Philippines, this is 102.5 strong radio in Santa Cruz, Davao del Sur. So you see strong radio hotline
on air.
And we are speaking about how the Lord changed our life because we are Christian. So we are sharing how the Lord changed our life, our witness. Here is the, I go online here. No, guardate ragazzi. No, the curve. Guardate ragazzi, ma è una cosa incredibile. Bette belle. What they eat. È incredibile. Guardate, poi c'è quella grande lì. Questo. Ma è incredibile. Vedi sì. Pare assolutamente fidelissimo. Cioè ragazzi, è spettacolare, e poi diventano giganti. Cioè guardate my hand is 22 centimetri. This is my fish, wait see. It's very peaceful. It's very peaceful.
Hello, wow. Wow, dagko kayo siya, oh. Dagko pa sa akong kamot. Hello. Dagang kaayo. Laminin siya to ano. Sa bawon. Hello ka. Sa bawon daw. Wow.
It's the famous dragon fruit. Oh, incredible.
Only one fruit you have.
Very rare.
Have you ever tried this?
Never.
May I try? I one time we buy so you can.
How much cost?
This I don't know. But I eat that last time when I was in Kuwait.
Incredible.
Yeah, this is the.
But this Asia.
This one, see? Dragon fruit.
So this cactus.
This look like a
cactus. And then exit this. The fruit that is called dragon fruit. Incredible. So there is also. This we eat already in the church. Wow.
There's also fruit, but it's not ripe.
Raga, this is the dragon fruit. This is a.
Also, there is a lanzones.
Like a cactus.
You never try. Ah, you remember we went last time?
It's like
the
a cactus, practically.
Black, 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 black,
black, black,
there is one fruit there inside.
There is the fruit.
There is also there, Andrea, look. There's a fruit there. Look. There's a fruit. Yeah. You see? There is a fruit there. That's a dragon fruit.
This is the dragon.
stasyon. Salamat ako mga kaugali. Mr. Didi, thank you. And Pastor Radyo, yakoban ako karoon. Nagpasalamat ko sa Diyos, bisan pa namin mga stasyon. Ma'am Beth, Sir Andoy, bisan pa Sir Indo, na nag-assist para sa Bulwaton, sige po, plastar ko ng mga stasyon. Nai-create sa akong pagkumangkong Sir Hitler, PNB, na-assign dito sa Kumbal, matatangin na kuli, create sa kuling ha, sa stasyon. Because our coverage in radio, kung ginawa yung tapatuli, pati mo Facebook, you can see us all over the world. Abisan ko, Kumbal na Tanyel, Pastor Rudy Rasay, Rogelio, Sunday, and Ma'am Angel. Thank you so much for watching me every Sunday. You can see Facebook live. So, may kukong Pastor Chaplin, Pastor Carpe Ihon, may Estrella Rudo, Pastor Andy, Brother Daniel Carpareria, and to my UPC co-pastor, Pastor Bruno Liscano, and Pastor Michael, may gabi ka ninyong tanan, and God bless you. And also, this announcement come to me. Pastor Richard Tubali and Sir Bayutas, together with Leticia Dabuan and Ma'am Angelina Tumon, General. Your announcement, Victor, that this coming July 25, there will be a meeting in Mangkilan Gym, Tagum City, July 25, and we need to assemble because they did not ask me the exact time, maybe 8 to 9, we are already meet there in Tagum Gym. And tonight, before I start preaching the gospel, I first introduce my companion, Brother Andrew, from Italy, and he need to greet his family in Italy. Sir, it's your turn.
Salamat to all the listener in Strong Radio 102.5. I'm Andrew from Italy. Thank you for this opportunity, and the Lord bless in the name of Jesus Christ. And now the pastor, she pray for us. Thank you.
And now I ask Pastor Radyo to pray to lead us.
Amagambota, mga kaigsunan, labing gamahanan o dalaygo nga Diyos, Ginoong Hesus, nanitak na sa kahaponon. Nagapasalamat kami ni mong istasyon o Diyos nga diin nga kahatag sila Ginoo kay kayunan aron kami makawali sa imong mga pulong Ginoo. Magapanalangin ikaw nanitak na sa kahaponon. Kanamong tanan o Diyos samtang bisan pa sa nagapataling sa imong mga pulong. Palayan mo Ginoo ang mong host, pastors, Pastor Rudolph Corazay. Kauban na mo o Diyos bisan pa kining 102.5 Strong Radio nga kiniginog gigamit alang sa imong kadunggalan ug kamayaan. Panalanginan mo kaming tanan o Dios, at tabon ni kami sa imong humili kadugo. Lord God, kini tanan mong gitugyan nga ang pinapasalamatan sa pangalan ni Kristo Jesus. Amen.
And tonight, let's study the book of Jonah. And what the Bible says about this message. Book of Jonah declares to us a disobedient man of God. Jonah's fear and pride caused him to run from God because he did not want that people in Nineveh needs to repent themselves. Jonah traveled 500 miles as we go on to travel, and this message happened 60 years before Israel and Judah split, and it's about 200 years before Jerusalem was destroyed. And now let's study the book of Jonah, because the title of my message program here, the message of the end time. Because God's before destruction of this world, first he asked Noah to build an ark, then Jonah, most of his prophet, Jeremiah, Isaiah, he called his people, because God doesn't want that anybody should perish, but they need to come to repentance. As we go on, what Amos says in his words, and the book of Jonah, Amos chapter 8, 11 to 12, this is Jonah says in his letter. Aniya karoon ang mga dilaw magot na, nagaingon ng ginong Jehova. Ngadiha sa itay padalapang kagutmanan, dili kagutmanan sa tinapay ni sa taos sa tubig. Hinno ang kagutmanan sa pagpatalinghog sa pulong ni Jehova. Huwag sila magalari-lari, gikan sa sangdagat. Ngato sa timugan, sila manalagan ng tungani aron sa pagpangita sa pulong ni Jehova. Huwag sila dili na makakaplag ni. And my uttermost prayer to God, before we are 7 pastors, we are here just preaching the gospel. Like Pastor Palarion Ramintal, my co-chaplain pastor, spending money, time, effort, how far from mental up to here. He needs to preach the gospel 3 times a week. And Pastor, may gabi kanino Pastor, and Pastor Dominic from Turil, daily from 7 to 7:30, he just came to preach the gospel, because we, Pastor, we love souls of the people. And I really thank God. Why? Because there are so many Christians departing from God when they heard the message of God, especially the gospel songs, they return back to serve the, our Lord in these last days. And my earnest prayer to God, Lord, bless pastors who love to preach your gospel, who love to preach your words in this station. Thank you, Sir Indong, Ma'am Beth, and Sir Undoy. Because of these facilities, you need to help people. You love souls of God, the saints of God. Because God loves people who come closer to God. Being a chaplain, see, this is our mission, this is our goal, is to let people of Davao del Sur going closer to God, and not only to the people of Davao del Sur. And thank you, God, because in these last days, because of I'm lack of financial status, thank you for my brother, Lito Rasay, retired PNP of Sulu. Mayang gabi kanimo, manong, sahig ko may katao sa Dios, may pinabangon ka. Akong mga pagampo, nga bisag asa ka, tabangan ka sa Dios. God covers you with His precious blood and His billions of angels wherever you go. And my prayer to God, because we have no father and mother, so continue to serve us, your sister, brother, because time will come. We can just meet only, we gather together in case we have situations like birthdays, there are someone who passed away, that is the time we can gather together. As we go on to our study, you know, Jonah was a man of God.
And the words of God came to Jonah. Stand up, go to Nineveh. And that's the city, 120 billion, capacity, million people. God hates that city. As we believe, God will repent. As what we read in Genesis chapter 6, verse 6, ang Diyos nagbasol na dibuhat niya ang tao. I just mix my message because some people do not know how, do not understand English. Time in Astor, I preach 1 hour in English. But one of our viewers in Laguna, Pastor Asay, just tell Pastor Bansag, just tell Pastor Asay, just mix his message. Let him speak Tagalog. So I preach Tagalog and Bisaya. On the time, I just mix my message, three dialect. And as of now, I'm pure native of Davao. I'm pure Bagubo, but I cannot understand most of the very deep language in Bagubo. God says to Jonah, go to Nineveh and shout on that city because the wickedness came to my side. But Jonah, upon si Jonah's mitindog, aron, pagkalagyo paingon sa Tarsis, nagkalagyo siya gikan sa tubangan sa Dios. Remember, Jonah was a rebellious man of God. And maybe I can teach this message for 1 month because I want to know, because every time I preach here, I have a time, but God changed it to my mind that I need to preach the gospel of Jonah. And I really believe, and this is this really situations as what is happening to our world today. But Jonah stand up, and God told him, go to Nineveh. But he got a ticket, go to Tarsus, because Jonah wants to flee from the sight of God. And on that time, as Jonah went to Tarsus, God sent a typhoon, very tragedy, things to happen to them. God sent a typhoon in the sea. Ug sa pagkaagi nga ang sakyan daw naguba na. So one thing to happen, every one of us, when we face a very difficult situation, as what Pastor preached this afternoon, Matthew 11:20, who among you will suffer, come to me and I will keep you rest. Because this kind of people, they themselves, as Jonah want to go to God, ask help from God, Jonah pray away from God. Nan, ang mga sakayan ng nangadlo, ugang tagsa-tagsa katawang isinggit sa pagpakitabang sa ilang Diyos, ug ilang gisalibay nga to sa dagat, ang uban nilang mga rulan sa sakayan, aron sa pagpagaan alang kanila. Apan si Jonah misulod sa gabing tago ng mga bahin sa sakayan, ug siya mihigda, ug nainanok sa hilabihang pagkatulog. We discuss it one by one, because last Sunday, when Pastor Rodi Arasay came to the station, he just testified how good God himself, because the doctor in Bangkal, they asked him 1.5 million just to give operation to his head. But because of prayer to all people all over the world, God healed him. And this is really true, how God miraculous God whom we serve. Because as what David says in Psalms 23, even I walk in the valley of death, I fear no evil, because God is with me. Then let us hear what the words of God says in Jonah chapter 1 verse 5. The people fear God, every one of us, every one of them, be once healed from God, their God. Then they threw their all their things in outside the sea to make their boat lighter. Then Jonah himself, going to the deepest place of the boat, and he is asleep. Then this is things that happen. When their eyes say, what is strategy that happens to us? As we go on board, there is no typhoon. And this is just the message of God to every people that hear the words of God in these last days. As what he says, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 3. Apan may tumud sa mga pitsa, apan may tumud sa mga panahon o mga pitsa. Mga igsoon kamo wala magkinahanglan nga pagkasulatan pa. Kay kamo nasay na pag-ayo nga adlaw sa Ginoo maubot sama sa kagawatan, sa kagabhion, sa diha nga tawo mga kanayon aniya ang kalinaw o kasiguruhan, sa kalit maubot kanila ang pagkalaglag. Maingon sa pagbati sa kasakit nga mabot sa kababay nga sila dili makaikyas. Tanaw na itong sitwasyon sa pagkakaroon. Dapit sa Middle East, 100 degrees na ang kainiton sa adlaw. I forgot that place because 20 people died already. Some of our place here in the Philippines, Many lives were lost because of flood, typhoons, lahar, tal, volcanoes. But thank God, any difficulties happen, the people of God still living peacefully. Apan may tumunod sa mga panahunog, mga pitsa, mga igsoon, kamula na magkinanglan, mga pagkasulatan pa. Kay kamo na side na pag-ayo nga adlaw sa Ginoo mabot ra sa masakawatan sa kagabhion, sa diha nga ang mga tao magkanayon ani ang kalinaw ug kasiguruan, sa kalit mabot kanilang pagkalaglag sa pagbati sa kasakit nga mabot sa kasakababay nga talianak, sila dili na makaikyas. How good God is. Long before destruction of the world, when God asked Noah, because you are the only man I see in this world, because you are a righteous man, build an ark, which the measurement of the ark is 475 feet long, 475 feet long, 75 feet wide, and 45 feet high. And at that time, Noah made an ark for 120 years. God wants people, all people, to be saved. But people on that time, they do not believe as what we are, people on this world. We believe. When we see that there is water. But Noah himself did not hesitate himself. He continued building the ark for 120 years. He used only one tree. The name of the tree is Gopher. He passed it. And the time Noah was in the ark for 6 days. Anything happened. Because there is no people. People all over the world. Can you imagine? Can we imagine? only 8 people will save. Because there is no people wants to enter into the ark. God asked Noah, just let 2 birds, 2 kinds of animals enter the ark. And at 12 noon, the world start to dark. The darkness comes all over the world. And at 3 p.m., God opened the most part of the earth. Water, the rain. And remember, the rain lasted for 140 days and 40 nights. And the rain lasted for 150 days. As of now, God did not punish people by water, but God will punish people in this world. Remember, what is our situation as of now? Revelation chapter 6, 16 verse 9, what the Bible says? 16 verse 9, huwag ang katawan ng apain sa ilabeng kain, a forgot city. 100 people already have died because 100 degrees Celsius, a very hot sun happened in that place. The people were burned because of the very hot sun. And they cursed God. People need to repent. And people need to examine as what happens in the days of Noah. People continue. As of now, they build houses, they marry, they eat, drink, whatever they do. But they did not repent. As what the situations long before. As we go. Okay. Tanaw na to unsa may panghitabo. Nagingon siya din. Si Jonas na ikatulog dito sa kinailauman sa kabin. Natulog si Jonas. Ano na may mga Kristo na natulog sa pagkakaroon? Why I am here? Because I just feel happy when somebody says to me, when I heard some Christians return back to God, and can you remember the message of the songs which that entered into my mind? Anak, balik na. And the sounds of his coming, you can hear that every time I need to preach the gospel. Romans chapter 11, Romans chapter 13 verse 11. Ugawas paninikamu sahid kunon sa nang panahon na karon. Ngatak na nakaroon ng kinahalan managmata ka mo gikan sa inyong pagkatulog. Samtang dito ko sa Chinsan, doon ay mga tao dito matagpan nila. Kanyan ako mato sa uma, kanang makainom na kong kapi. Pagkawa nila kinong kapi, maabot man ang bisita dito sa saranggan ni Pastora. Maabot na po ng bisita, mayroon sila, mamahaos ako. Hangtod magalas niyo nila. Kanyang mayro ba, dito sa tadibay ang ilang anak, 13, 14 ka buo. Damera daw yun ni Pastora. So, pagkabot sa alas 9, init naman ang adlaw. Mani ito sa ako. Bulat na ko galauna. Init pa man. Pagkabot sa launa, naanap ang bisita mo abo. Kanya, mga pisa ko. Sa ako matuguman. Hantun niya po, tog alas 3, alas 4. Isa ka adlaw, walay agi. Pagkadako sa area dito, pagkadako sa ilang yuta. Ditong napita, I just observe how good God is. There is a time when the people of God service starts. They can call on God even at midnight. Then a group of armed men threw grenade inside the church. But this is what happened. The people of God just jumped inside the church. And the people outside, they hurt because of the bullets. And I really believe. I have one of the members who visited us in Laman. 5 bullets of 4-5. Did not enter to his body because God covers him. And there's one time I heard that testimony. What God do in their life when they need to worship God. When the unwarned armed men target the people, members of the church, sense of God inside the church, they use 14 grenade rifle. But every time they use to target the body, they see a white blanket cover the people of God. And that armed man was baptized in Jesus' name. What kind of people are these? I know the life of Pastor Moriti. Pastor Joe know who is Pastor Moriti. It bullets enter into his body. But the time, every bullet, they just slide in his mouth. I can see inside his heart. They put the gun inside his heart. But the bullet just slide. People of God, in this last day, just wake up. Because I really believe God loves you. He do not want anybody to perish. Bisan pa karuman din sa relevision. Salamat. Pagkita nagsimbahan. Mamatapanin mo dito ka mga langit kay Pastor Rudy Rasay sa relevision. Sa di papabot sa Diyos sa ngayong katalagman. Kiningamin sa'yo sa awit, mapatalin mo ba ninyo? And it will recall the mind of the people. Especially to Brother Lonson Ipas of Cacas Village, Pastor Camilo Angat, Pastor Melissa. May gabi sa inyo ha. Nining katapos ang mga adlaw, maglinig unay ta. Sa atong mga pag-ampo sa Diyos, nalikunan ta sa Ginoo. Ugawas panini ka mo sahib, kunon siya ng panahon na karoon. Na kinalan managmata ka mo gikan sa pagkatulog. Doon na ba'y panahon na mga Kristana ng matulog di ay sa pagpangalaga. But when you really believe as what God says in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Let us first only obey the words of God. As we continue, kaya nga itong kaluwasan, labaw pa ka dool ka na po karoon. Kaysa diha nga bago pa kitang mito. Romans 13 verse 12. Ang kagabhion talitapos na. Uga nga dilaw nagsingabot na. Busa isa ni kweta ang mga buhat sa kangitit. Uwisulog na ang hinagiban sa kahayap. I just share to you, what will we do in these last days? As what the Apostle Paul says in Romans and Ephesians chapter 5, busa, pagbantay kamo pag-ayos sa inyong paggawi. Dili ingon nga mga buong buwan, kundili ingon ng mga masinabuton. Every Christian, this is just I remind to every one of us. What is the will of God in our life? And everything we do, is it the will of God? So, for me, I think it is the will of God. Financial status is very difficult for me. I've been lending 2.7 every month, 2.6 for my motor. Before I need to pay 3K in this station. Lord, I cannot sacrifice this because of lack financial status. But I really believe if God, but if it is the will of God to continue preaching this station, every Sunday I just let my co-pastors and my members to join with me. Because as what I see in Laman Church, I can leave every time I was out. Funeral service, I can assign in church. But only two things which I cannot assign to them. One is in this station, and number two, my work in the municipality of Santa Cruz. Before I was teaching in school, 5 years in public school, I do it voluntarily because my love of God and to His work. Nga managpahimulos kamusta kay gayunan, kaya ang kapanahonan karon puno sa kalisdanan. I just play 2 songs from start until the end. So this song always reminds of us the situation as of now. Maybe I cannot finish 1 month in the book of Jonah. Because let us see, and we need to study, because this is the words of God whom God needs to remind me. Long before I need to use my books, but God needs to remind this on my mind. And we need to study the book of Jonah. And let us go. Busa ang rice sa sakayan, may adto kaniya, o minum kaniya. Unsay imong ipasabot, o hinga tulugon. Tindog daw ang imong Diyos, basin pa ang Diyos, magap huna-huna, tungod ka na to, aron dili kita mamatay. Most people as of now are afraid to die. Every time I used to commit death in the cemetery, one of my pastors says, when there is a wedding ceremony, and the lady threw a flower at the back, and many lady wants to cut that flower because they are the next one to marry. But one thing, when the pastor throw flower, who wants next to die, no one will accept it. Brother, are you ready to die?
In the Lord God.
No. If it is the will of God, every time. Because the last enemy of God is death, as what we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 26. As what Apostle Paul says, the last enemy of God is death. We have 4 enemies. And what are the enemies of the true Christians? The devil, the world, and let us read John, first John 16, 33. John 16, 33. Gisulti ko kini kaninyo, aram din ikan ako makapatun ka magkalinaw. I just tell it to you that in this world you must have peace. But the real situations of this world, the peace whom people need to win is only 3.5 years. And we need to choose. One of my co-pastors says, open online on Friday, and the real situations of this world, it will really happen anytime this year. Gisulti ko kini kaninyo ang aron nga dinhi kanako makabaton kam kalinaw. Dinhi sa kalibutan 16:33 of John. Dinhi sa kalibutan aduna kami kagulaanan. Apan sumali kam gidaog kuna ang kalibutan. What is the most important to us is our trust in God. As we read in Luke chapter 8 verse 40 up, when the lady, she has nothing to sell, house, land, ATM, anything, what he obtained already lost because of his sickness. But what is the desire of her heart? Because that lady heard about Jesus, and this is her motive. When I touch the bottom dress about Lord Jesus, I be healed. She is very positive. Every time Christians go to God, they need to have the gospel. There's so many opposition. There's so many barriers that because Satan do not want any people to go to God. But that lady herself, she didn't hesitate herself to go to God. And when he sit at the place of the dress, because of our Lord Jesus Christ, she was here. And this is what God says. Dini sa kalibutan, aduna kami kaguluanan. Apan gidaog ko na ang kalibutan. I have only 15 minutes. 14 minutes to speak. And as I continue, Peter chapter 5, let us listen. 14 minutes preaching the gospel. Bulahan ng tao, Revelations, first I read Revelation chapter 1 verse 3. Bulahan ang tao ngadto sa kapunungan magabasa. And this is not a good reason. Pastor Radio was so very blessed because he has sister who are abroad, and every time she sends package of money to her. Tingaw na, Dili. Na-texon sa gawa? Kapit na ganit daw. So, bulahan ang tao mato sa kapun. Ang bulahan, Dili. We read the Bible. Revelation chapter 1 verse 2. Blessed is the man who reads the words of the prophecy. Prophecy of bulahan. Number 2. When they listen, read that. Listen and obey.
Hear the words of this prophecy.
Yes.
And keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand.
Listen, I cannot see the viewers. breakfast is so very bad. Okay, panayon ta. Ang bulahan katong mga tao na nagapatalinghog. Ako nang naibawan. From inawain to ba to? This, because this is only the coverage of our radio station. From inawain to ba to? It's only the coverage. But time will come on television because it is under negotiation. All pastors who are preaching here in this station, they can see us on television. But as of now, only radio, televisions, but it is very bad because Facebook, they can see us all over the world. What is my prayer? Innermost part, that God will bless all pastors who are preaching here in this station, because on these last days, we can read in Amos chapter 8:11. This is the day that what God wants every one of us. We can listen, and we can read in Revelations, verse 1 Peter chapter 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7. Itugyan nga to kaniyang tanan ninyong kabalaka kay siya may kangaw man kanina. When I trust God, I let myself survive whatever situations that happens to me. Among our brothers and sisters, I'm the poor among the poorest. Even to us pastors, I'm so very poor. But this is just what can I say. I just encourage myself to serve God sincerely, faithfully, honestly. Because every time God says to me a vision, it will really happen. As what Jeremiah 33:3 says, call unto me and I will answer thee. And our secret things which you have not seen. Usa akong mga pag-ampos sa Diyos. 18 katawid niya kaampo ko ako tubaga, pero ako maluya. Pero maabot ang tog mga panahon. Natapangan ko sa Dino. Ang saman akong mga pag-ampos sa Diyos. Ako ang ginuoray na sayod niyo. And you na, let us continue. Basing pa ang Diyos maguna-una tungod ka na to aron kita tili mga matay. What is so good as of now? When we die before the mark of the beast comes, Antichrist comes, or when we die and which is called the rapture of the church? When we read Isaiah, just read in Isaiah chapter 57 verse 1. This is what I really believe. Anything happens. Isaiah, go closer to microphone. Isaiah 50, I just searched it. Isaiah 57 verse 1. Read it in English version. Because
this is King James version. The righteous perish, and the man hath it to heart. Merciful men are taken away, none considering that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come.
Okay. Tanaw na to, ah. Ang matarang mawagtang, o wala tao nga manumbaling inis yan kasing-kasing. And this is the time of rapture. You cannot see rapture in the Bible because Egypt, as what we have read, seen in the Bible. Ang matarong mawagtang, huwag walang tao nga manumbaling dini sa iyong kasing-kasing. Huwag ang mga tao nga malili ang kinakuha. Huwag nagpamanandong ang matarong kinakuha gikan sa umalabot ng kadaatan. People will so amazed and be surprised because this is really happened to every one of us. Because good people of God, servants of God, living in a holy life, this is what he says. In Luke chapter 17, verse 34, what he says? 17:34 of Luke. 17:34.
I tell you, that night there shall be two men in one bed. The one shall be taken, the other shall be left.
When I ask you a question, is this really true? You was already baptized in Jesus' name, and your wife stepped in. And on that time, when a trumpet needs to ring, because this is near to unyang kabiyon na duha katawa na sa usa kay daan, ang usa kuhaon ug ang usa mabiyaan. So alaaw tong mga pamilya nga ang asawa nagakanta sa Terjoy atong aging Domingo, ang bana ma-rapture, ang asawa mabili, ang asawa ma-rapture ug ang bana mabili.
Do you like it?
When your wife would be raptured and you will believe?
No.
Yes, that is in reality. Because yes, on the words of God, on that night, because when two families serving God, they two together were put up to heaven, and this is called rapture. Doing this ministry is a very difficult time, because what we read, we have something to discuss. 1 Corinthians 15:58, this is what the Bible says. 1 Corinthians 15:58. Read it. 58. Ah. Kapastor, basig doon na kayo ngayon mo. Yes, sir. 15:58, the 1 Corinthians.
Read it.
Hindi ko makita sa mga konsol. And thank you mga viewers. So I just accept what your comments. Like Pastor Pilio, Pastor maing gabi sa inyo. Matagpanin mo. Pastor Asay, sige, popcorn din na. Anong sige, magulaan ng mga magwala sa phone. Sige, pati sa mga phone. Thank you Pastor Pilio, for your comments. Every time what comments I need to hear from you, I will do it, because there is a saying, failure is the way to success. I do not need to comment anyone, because I'm not a perfect man. So, how many viewers I cannot see. So, thank you for watching me. So, as what we read, 1 Corinthians 15:58, let us see.
15:58. Yes. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
What can you say about that verse? As what Apostle Paul says, I knew you have started Bible school with Pastor Nick Perez. Thank you, Pastor Nick Perez. I know you can see me. We are here. We are poor. Mr. DB, your student. And Brother Andrea, your student. We are here in this station. Pastor Radio, they are your student. So, may gabi ka niyo, Pastor. I know you are live on Facebook. But I cannot see most of the time. Because only sometimes I can get this message. Busa ini kung makong mga igsoon, kinahanglan magpakaligun kamo. Dili matarod sa kanan ay magbada kayo sa buloton sa Ginoo. You leave your child, your very handsome boy in your house, because you just want to come to this station so that you can greet your father. All your mother in Italy, your brother and sister, because what is managayaon sa blotan? Abiding the word of the Lord, work of the Lord. Huh? Yes. Busay ni kong akong mga igsoon, kinalan magmadagayaon kamo. Dili matarok sa kanong na magmadagayaon sa blotan. Is it the word of God? Very night na. 7 p.m. na. Beaker from here is so very bad. So, you have love for the work of God. Maybe the next time you can visit us. You can give you time. Just learn to speak Cebuano. Because there are times when I can hear somebody, Pastor Asay, masulti po ka Tagalog para makasabot me. Because our brother, sisters in Luzon cannot understand Bisaya. They can understand English because only few. So tonight, only one language I cannot speak here, Bagubu language. I'm not a saint or tradition because I'm pure Bagubu, but I cannot understand what Bagubu language is because most of the time we are speaking Dabuin. So I have few more times. I want to rest because this is maybe I can speak about the book of Jonah because this is the guiding principles what God has given to me. The book of Jonah. Do naman may mga balatian din ha. Because I have observed people in Japan only to. There are already top people in Japan. When Brother Ricky and Starving Pino says to me, Pastor, pray this woman in the hospital of Japan. But God healed her. One in Thailand, she is in a hospital asking me, Pastor, pray. So whatever sickness, difficulties she faces, Brother Ricky smile, I'm here. Peace in a very difficult situation, but just believe God. Time will come, I can visit you. Just consider yourself in the presence of God. God loves you. I really believe there's power in here. Remember this message. What is the will of God? Everywhere, every one of us, God has a purpose. Let us consider God, the presence of God. Matthew 11:28. Just read it. Matthew 11:28.
Give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls, for for my yoke is his and my burden is light.
Pati, le nasar kuncai harusnya terpisah suka. Whatever situations you have, pain is up now. Just raise your hand, right hand. And whatever situations, any illness you face, you feel strong. Really believe, because God is the omnipotent God. He is everywhere. God is here in this station. He led me because we pastors are the mouthpiece of God. God can help you. Just be humble in the sight of God. Who we are, God. Ginoo ng dapat sa kagabihan. Lord, dili mi perpekto sa imong atubangan sa panahon. Apan nagapaubos kami sa among kaguligod, Ginoo. Kay kami nagatuog kung wala ta, wala kami mahibo sa among kaguligod. Ginoo sa tanang panahon. Makahibo ka pag-usap sa among mga kinabuhi. Sa mga tao na nagkinahanglan sa ibang mga panabang. Ginoo, dili ko gusto nga doon sa gumawala. Kundi lang tanan mga dangat din sa paghinulsun. Imong kaya din mong usabon ang among mga kinabuhi. Salamat ka ganyan sa pagwala ni Pastor Radyo. Nga ikaw, Ginoo, makausap sa among mga kinabuhi. But in these last days of God, let our hearts be molded by the power and authority which you have given to your servant. Sa tanang mga Kristohanan na tinadanay, ginagalagat sa Diyos, Ginoo, ay aming pasanggay. Sa panahon sa pagkalisunod Diyos, adlakas sa among kiniran.
Amen.
Itugot to Diyos ng lugang kalikod kanasig o Diyos sa sitwasyon sa mga pastor ginugusto mabuha apan na sa pinansyal ng mga bahay na sa everyone of God sa mata ko sa kalamog Ginoo mga panalangin ka o Diyos haron kami mga panayon sa patawag at uyon sa imong kabuton nining dapit sa kagabihon salamat o Diyos sa imong kaya tanang sa ngalan ng Diyos sa saling ang tanang
rustling in the summer breeze as I see the Lord restore Jerusalem and I can hear a sound from heaven.